This place provides a way for staff to grow. What it really, I guess, in a word, if I could sum up what I've learned about this place, it's growth, whether that's spiritual, physical, even emotional, mental growth. You know, people come here, participants and especially staff, come here and they've never been here before, a lot of them. But they leave having grown and realizing more their potential that they have. And they're ready to go forth as disciples and help others realize their potential as well.
All right, Carly Calder, tell us about training.
Training week was probably the biggest adventure of my life. I probably had my feet froze more often than I ever have in my entire life. The first day was actually kind of a joke, is what we called it. It snowed so much overnight, and we all were not aware that we had to park our cars down below in the lower parking lot, and all got stuck. Like, literally every single car got stuck. And then, in the process of trying to get other cars unstuck, I believe, with the big truck, sports truck, I was driving in the car with Dan, sitting next to him, and he backed up into the snowbank. I don't know. We got the truck stuck.
So we got Alexa's car out. Look at that, us women. And now Dan got his truck stuck.
Brilliant.
Now we're digging this puppy out.
Right after saying it was impossible to get it stuck.
That's
he
right.
Said, he literally said it would take a lot to get this truck stuck.
And
this is a lot.
Look at that.
We got the truck stuck. And then we got the tractor stuck. And then we got something else stuck.
Snowblower.
Yeah.
Yeah, like the John Deere.
It's just like
I know it sounds weird, but I feel like even though it seems like the worst thing ever to get all your cars stuck, it was actually a blessing for us because we totally had our first bonding experience. And we learned how hard the other girls were willing to work and how well we could work together already from day one. And I love that.
Okay, so training. What we did for training the first week out here was like, we started with ropes course. We didn't even start there. The first thing we did for training was we started with how to tie ropes and learning different knots and, you know, how to be prepared for when we actually use the ropes course. We had to know the certain knots to do. I don't even know. Okay, and then another thing we had to learn about was like the local procedures or rules, and then like how our procedures rules are a little different because they're a little special in a way. Anyways, so training, what we did like the first week, we started with Dangling Duo and had my awesome partner Carly who helped me all the way up, so that was pretty cool. And then next thing we did was the power pole, and that was fun. Then after the power pole, we did the rock climb with zip line, and that was super scary. I'm terrified of heights, so it wasn't really fun for that one, but it was a good experience. And then it was just more of like applying all that with our facilitating and just working together.
What did you learn about facilitating during training?
What we learned about facilitating during training was how to ask the right questions to the groups and how to get them involved and get them, you know, focused on what they were trying to accomplish here at Badger Creek.
Did you feel like you were prepared?
Prepare-wise? At the beginning, I felt super nervous, super scared. We had, like, training went by so quick, I thought we'd, like, probably have more practice to do on each other. But it was just, we had our first group, and it was scary, the first group, but it was definitely worth it because they helped me learn And then throughout the rest of the semester, I felt more prepared.
So basically, we were kind of able to have our own experience in a very dramatic way before any before we were able to watch other people have that experience. It was kind of fun to spend like hours at a single ropes course learning it, but also watching each other accomplish our fears.
All right, tell me like about the structure of our classes.
So we have one class a day, Tuesday through Friday. We have a different teacher come each day. Some of them teach two classes, but each teacher teaches for 3 hours. We start class at 9 a.m, right after doing our daily to-dos. And then we have class till noon, when we get to go to lunch.
What is your favorite class?
My favorite class is probably experiential education and program management, because our manager here, Dan, teaches those classes for us, and he's really passionate about what he teaches, and it makes it matter a lot. And so I really enjoy what I come away with from that class. It makes you think, and it makes you, I feel like I learn more in that class than I do most classes.
So we took 16 credits up here because we don't winter camp class. Cross-country ski class, program, experiential education, facility management, and risk management, and all of those had to do with the magic tree. Everything we learned in class, we got to incorporate that day, which was really interesting. My favorite class was probably winter camping and cross-country ski, because we got to go outside, we got to go for a 5-hour trek in the woods.
We are headed out on our 3-day camping trip, and everyone is really happy to be here.
I'm so happy right now.
Throw it back.
Why?
Say goodbye to Dan again.
Yeah, bye.
Bye, Dan.
Bye, Keith. And Keith.
And Keith.
Save us.
We're
gone. Yeah.
Ashley, wave, and Tessa, wave to the camera. We're videoing this.
Don't miss us too much.
Oh, I can.
Or you can.
Don't
steal
okay
a mail.
If you want to.
Okay, we probably won't miss you that
one.
Oh.
That's unfortunate.
We'll see if we come back.
Have fun keeping this place clean without us.
Yeah, have fun doing family day alone.
Hey, Megan, what are you nervous for?
We're not going to come back for family day.
We have to pack out our waste.
And, Taylor, what's going to be in that waste?
Even the pee.
And periods.
Yes, I just wrote it down.
And poop.
61937.
All of it.
So here we are. This is the base of the mountains.
Base camp.
And we're hiking this.
What is it
today? Base camp. It's Hay Shape right now. Kendall, tell me how you're feeling right now. Oh my god.
Written in these walls are the stories that I can't explain. I leave my heart open, but it stays right here empty for days. She told me in the morning she don't feel the same about us in her bones. Seems to me that when I die, these words will be written on my stone.
Coming around the corner of a long day. We've been out here for like 5 hours. Literally not joking. And here we are. Here it is.
Woohoo! The story of my life.
was a
so nice.
Trick.
Putting our books. Oh my gosh, that feels so good. Oh my gosh, you're a trooper. Oh my goodness. Oh, thank you.
Yeah. But it stays right here in its cage.
And it's like a palace.
Am I talking to you as if I'm interviewing?
Oh, yeah. Sure, yeah.
Yeah, ask her questions.
Yeah. Okay.
So, this trip, how has it been?
I really liked it a lot.
What have we done?
A lot of fun. What have we done?
Yeah.
We snowshoed in 3 miles and then set up camp, I guess, in the tent thing. And then we had to build our Quincy. He made dinner.
How long did it take you to hike in?
What was it, like 5 hours? 4 or 5 hours. For 3 miles. Which is pretty bad. But the elevation gain was
1,200.
Which is kind of a lot. And stupid snowshoes.
But they're
just kidding, I like them a lot because you float.
Carly, you learned something cool this trip.
I did one of my first wilderness peas ever.
Woo!
It was way better than peeing in that bucket. Just so you know, over there,
stupid bucket.
They're draining. Gross.
The contents of the bucket.
At this moment. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that was a little.
Maybe we shouldn't film it then.
Have evidence. Our extra clips
we are so proud of Carly for peeing outside. It's the best thing ever.
I can do it for the rest of my life.
You will do it for
freedom.
The rest of your life.
Freedom.
Now you can pee on the side of the road.
You can pee anywhere.
I know, I'm so excited.
Family day.
We have to pack out our waste.
And Taylor, what's
all
your
of
pee
it,
that waste?
Even the pee
and periods.
Yes, I just wrote it down.
And poop.
6, 1, 9, 3.
Here we have just disposed of our biggest burden, the poop bag, as we call it. And Ashley has a big smile on her face. You cannot see it, but it is there.
Yeah.
Oh, that's me.
And it was so hard, but it was super awesome and a really good experience.
What do I say?
Look at you and your stance.
Oh my gosh, I'm like shaking.
Why are you shaking?
What do you want me to say?
Okay, hold on.
What are we asking you about?
Tell us.
Oh, sorry. What class are we talking about? Tell us about your experience. Well, actually, tell us what the cross-country skiing and winter camping class entails.
Okay, so they're kind of a combined class. Both of them are with Sven, which is awesome because Sven is cool. I'm sure Brenna can attest to that. Yeah, we learned how to cross-country ski. I'd done it a little bit before, but got a lot more experience, which was awesome, and it's a lot of fun. Really good workout. We did, like, I think our first ski besides just at Badger was Teton Canyon, which is like 8 miles, and we all did wonderfully. I was like super proud of us. We all did it, and we all did awesome. And skied Mesa Falls, and
we skied at Harriman.
Harriman.
We're cross-country skiing on icy paths of death, but we get to see swans, so it's worth the injury of our bodies.
It's real pretty out here.
And Taylor and Megan are coming up behind us. They're struggling a bit.
Slowly.
We have a real rough time. Megan's, She's trying really hard. They're struggling a bit.
Slowly.
We have a real rough time. Megan's,
And then
for the winter camping part, we've done like avalanche awareness. We had like an avalanche expert come. We've built a lot of quinches.
We just created this snow cave. Holla at your girl. Ow, ow. Say hi, Alyssa. Carly, say hi. Come here. Come in here. Come here.
I can't see.
You can see. Come on. Come on, Carly.
Wow. This is
troubling.
So we are doing our outdoor camping night here. And it is 15 degrees or colder.
Ow. I don't think it's that cold.
It is actually in my car.
Is it really?
Degrees. Yeah.
Oh.
Taylor and Asher and our Quincy Hitty campus. And we're sleeping outside and it'll be
so it's like an Indian man.
White man Indian.
White man Indian.
Here we are.
Squaw, take him selfie.
Squaw, no, get firewood. Squaw, go
sleep
home.
Sleep him outside. Squaw, no, sleep him outside. Squaw, go inside. Squaw, be happy in there.
Oh, sorry.
Oh.
I'm sorry.
Oh, goodness.
We are in a teepee for outdoor camping class. And Keith let us sleep in this super cool teepee tent thing. With hay that he put on the ground.
You should ask me how I'm feeling right now, Mel.
How are you feeling, Ashley?
Mel just woke me up.
Sorry.
I'm just kidding, I wasn't actually asleep yet. I can't breathe.
Really? Oh, dude, you have hay allergies and we're sleeping on hay.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, shoot.
The bombing.
Megan, what's going on?
My breath
smells
so bad.
Ew. Kendall, I was worried that Kendall was gonna die last night from hay fever.
She was all weak and I'm like, are you breathing?
Shook her pulse.
I'm getting really good at it because last night when we built ours, we got like, or not last night. Whenever we built ours this trip, we were like fast and it was like, we knew what we were doing. So we're like, snow shelter experts now, basically. And Megan and Carly won a Quincy competition. It's pretty cool. They had like steps and then a slide around it. So they definitely deserve to win that. Yeah, we learned about avalanches. We had a guy from Knowles come out to judge our Quincy's. That was really cool. He had a lot of knowledge. So we're really blessed to like...
You know, we have these rec management students that are in this major, and they can take classes on campus, and there's absolutely nothing wrong with those classes. They're powerful learning environments, and there's a lot can be learned there. But there's something about learning those same principles here, because here you actually have hands-on experience. Think about program management. What could be better than learning about program management, and then also going out planning and implementing a program here on the ranch? And not only planning and implementing, but you get to run programming the whole time that you're here. You know, if you think about facility management, you know, you can plan and talk about that as well in a classroom, but when you actually come here, you see more behind the scenes of what goes on when you're trying to run a facility. What are the things that you have to do? So it really is a hands-on learning experience. And I think that the value of that is indefinite. Every participant that's come here has told me, at least the ones that I've had under my stewardship, they've told me how deeply significant that's been and how much they've learned. And a lot of that learning came through, again, those hands-on experiences.
Program management is really cool because you get to see all the different groups that come up. And facilitate them depending on their needs. Like if they're coming for team building activities, then we can do activities that will build teamwork, or if they're just coming for fun, we can just like have fun with them.
just depending on what they're coming for, we get to design their program around the goals that they've set before they come.
We were able to plan our own programs, which was super cool because usually they just plan like a pretend program when they take the class on campus. But we were able to plan a program and actually do it and see what went wrong and things that we could improve. And then we like redid it and we improved it the next week. And it was like really cool to be able to do that. I helped a lot with the planning for the first family day. That was probably the one that I helped the most with. And it was really cool because we had to like meet with the people on campus and organize everything that way and figure out like what we wanted. And we kind of started from scratch a little bit. And it was just a really good experience because we actually learned how to like have our own program and how to plan it and actually carry it out instead of it being like pretend.
Dan always says a good program is in a constant state of development, and you can definitely see it.
So what kinds of groups do we get up here and what do they do?
A lot of the time during winter especially, we get groups to use our sled hill. It's kind of a big attraction during this time of year. Most of the time we have university groups. As a university entity, we try to cater to the university students. So we'll get wards coming up here a lot of the time or different departments from campus coming up to use it. Other than that, we'll often get community groups.
So when the group first gets here, we want them to sign a waiver, which is just right here. And then we usually mark their hand to make sure that everybody signed the waiver. And then we just give them an orientation depending on what they're doing. Like if they're doing the sled hill, we tell them like don't do any jumps, like make sure to use the tow rope, don't tie your clothes onto the tow rope, just stuff like that. If they're just doing ropes courses, then we just tell them about the wildlife around, just watch out for things. And we tell them about challenge by choice
because you can choose the level that you participate, and it's awesome because everyone is at a different level and everyone has like their own strengths and weaknesses. So when we were training and had to do like the giant swing and the power pole and everything, I hate heights so very much, and I hate falling. I hate that feeling of like free fall. I don't know why, but I hate both of those. And both of those were combined in both of these ropes courses. And I was so terrified and I did not want to do it. And it took me forever to be able to do it. But I felt like I grew a lot and I showed myself that I can do stuff like that. And then it's not embarrassing if I can't do it all the way or if I can't I guess. But it was really cool because everyone totally respected that, because we do have challenge by choice and we can all participate at the level at which we are comfortable. And that is where I was comfortable, and that was in my growth zone, and I wasn't super panicked. I was almost panicked, but it was like right before then, and it was perfect because I learned a lot and I feel like I grew a lot. So yeah, I really like challenge by choice.
And then also tell them about like the atmosphere at Badger Creek. Try not to use sarcasm, lift each other up instead of bringing them down. And then after that, just let them go.
One thing I learned about having like different age groups up here is that you can't like do things the same with each group because each group is different. So 12-year-old boys are not entertained by the same things that like 18 and 19-year-olds are entertained by. And so I think that I really got to learn how to consistent changing. You have to change consistently or like people get bored of your programs. And having different age groups up here, I think we really got to learn that you can't just have the same playbook over and over again. You have to change things up, and you have to know who you're facilitating to, or like it doesn't have the same effect.
Especially my second group, they kind of started out struggling a lot, and then throughout the whole few days that they were here, after they'd done all these teamwork activities and they'd, you know, conquered the power pole and they'd gone through the spider web together and all this stuff, and they really became more cohesive, and that was really, really cool to see. And it was really cool to see the things that they learned from doing initiatives and ropes courses. Things that I never would have thought of that they could apply to their major. And so.
Hello.
My personal job, it was super cool. We got to like pick what we wanted to do. And I got to do recycling up here, which is like a big deal for me because I'm very passionate about sitting here. And we live in God's land. And so it's really important for us to take care of it. And I got to like actually start something up here and like, see it too.
So my personal job is organizing and cleaning supplies for everybody who needs them. So when we do daily cleaning, so there's a part here that says bathroom cleaning kit. So you just pull out the bathroom cleaning kit and it has everything you need. So it has disinfectants, it has like mirror cleaner, it has trash bags, soap refills, anything you need. So that way it'll be a lot easier when you need your job every morning, you just pull it out.
I love working in the kitchen and I love all of that stuff and I love
take inventory and we make sure like the fridge is all cleaned out and all that stuff, but the best thing about the personal job is that we get to do what we like. We weren't just like forced to do something random. We all got to pick what we did kind of, and we all got to do what we excel in, and I love it, and I feel like I gained a lot of good experience.
Tell me about your personal job.
So, my personal job was that I'm the equipment manager this semester. Basically, that means dealing with ropes course equipment. This is the ropes closet cupboard thing under the stairs. And in here, we just have all of our different gear, whether retired or new and ready to be used. And I kind of was in charge of organizing it all, which I'm kind of still in the process.
Oh my gosh, first aid certified! Are you okay? Are you okay? You, call 911. You get an ADD. Okay, with my personal job, I was the first aid person. And with this, we need these cool kids. We need these cool kits, and so within these kits, basically what I had to do was you organize them into their own little section, which comes with a piece of paper to tell you exactly what is in those sections. So if someone's hurt on the job, through the ropes courses, or wherever, you can fill out an incident report, and then also...
So, I was given the job of being in the kitchen, Carly, and it was so much fun. It's really exciting, I think, and I really like it. I think that it was a really like good opportunity for me to get involved with groups and stuff, because we would prepare the food and like give them food and everything, and they were always like so happy that it's not like pizza, it's like a real meal, and they're like, oh, who made this? And then me and Carly would be like, oh, well, we did, because we're awesome.
Do I want with staff as much hands-on experience with facilities issues as possible, whether it be working with certain types of tools or certain aspects of taking care of the property. For the staff to learn as much as possible about managing a facility and all the aspects of that. So to walk away with more a broader base of experience and the skill set would enable them to not only be useful in other places of employment, but also just more useful as husbands and mothers and fathers, more prepared to go out into the world and do what it's going to be required to do to take care of your own home and different property. A skill set that will help you wherever you go. Hands-on skill set.
I actually really love work crew. It's kind of fun. I love it because it's never the same thing twice. Work crew is basically just the ranch work. Whatever needs to be done, we just kind of do it. We have work crew twice a week on Wednesdays and Fridays after lunch. And we have done anything from taking down an old fence and burning it to cutting down bushes or just getting ready for a group to come, cleaning cabins and things.
Caught a lot of mice.
We go check the mouse traps and stacking wood, shoveling snow a lot of the time. It's actually a lot of fun, I think. You get to work hard and get to do lots of different things, learn new skills.
And our sinks are like overflowed with sick nasty in them. And Kendall and I are going to clean this, and Kendall is super itchy because she has fleas.
I really think you should witness.
Okay.
The fullness, that is not just,
I can't breathe.
No, I'm staying over here.
Scoop it out with.
Well, get a plastic spoon.
That'll do this whole thing!
And Keith, our facilities manager here, is in charge of work crew, and he's awesome. He teaches you how to do new things. We get to drive the truck and back up the trailer and use the snowblower to get rid of, to clear paths when it's snowy, and just all different types of things. I love it. It's fun, actually, just all the different stuff we get to do.
Lean for my heritage!
What was the first one? Your integrity?
My integrity!
Your integrity!
Which is pretty much the same thing.
Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us. Your playing small does not serve the world. There is nothing enlightened about shrinking so that other people won't feel insecure around you. We were all meant to shine as children do. It's not just in some of us, it's in everyone. And as we let our own light shine, we unconsciously give other people permission to do the same. As we are liberated from our own fear, our presence automatically liberates others.
Group leader.
I'm kidding, Kendall. No, group leader, it was a cool experience. You definitely got to see the other side of everything else. I mean, yeah, there goes with facilitating and knowing how to work with people, but group leader is definitely a stressful but beneficial job in the end, because you get to communicate with campus and you get to communicate with, like, your group and, you know, provide a program throughout the week that makes everyone happy, and in the end, you're happy. And just to show you, these are the things that might drive people crazy. You get texts about everything they need, every little detail, which is totally cool and good, but you're planning it the last day, last second, and it's a little stressful.
It's a good experience, because as a group leader, you get to see what goes on behind the scenes. The parts that you don't usually think of, the organization and the structural stuff, and all the planning that goes into the administration side of places like this and jobs like this.
The easiest part about being group leader is that everyone's so willing to work, and we all want the groups to be successful, so we all work together, and it works together really well. I think we all have really good dynamics in our group that help us to work together really nicely.
The easiest thing about being a group leader was that I definitely had a lot of support, both from Dan and everybody on the staff.
If you have a good group and you know how to talk to people well, everything works out perfectly. But if you're a little too straightforward, or you just don't know how you work, it could be difficult. So just trying to, like, work through that and just work through, like, you know, at the end of the day, it's going to be over and it's going to be fun. And that's what you're here for.
Knowing the answers to questions that you've been asked before, and having to problem solve right on the spot, and not having someone to call and ask them. A lot of times, Dan was over here at Badger Creek, and so solutions to problems right on the spot, and be confident in that. The first weekend was like crazy because we had no idea what to do. It was our first week as a leader ever, so we didn't know what to do, and there was like problems with communication like that. And when people are here, you have to be able to help them, even if you have no idea what you're doing yourself, but you're just confident that they'll believe it. And so,
that it's kind of hard to be the leader, because everyone is like totally looking to you, and we are all switching out as being leaders. And so we know.
The hardest part was learning my responsibilities. I felt like it took me the entire 2 weeks as a group leader to figure out what I was doing. By the time I had it down,
it was over. So I was grateful for being able to learn in that way and not be told everything, because I feel like I learned a lot more about being a leader because I kind of had to figure it out.
The hardest part about being a group leader was definitely trying to figure out what I was doing. It's not something I've ever done before. It's not something I have experience with, really leading things like that, like planning and...
What will you take away from your experience of being group leader? Like, how will you apply that to your normal life?
I learned a lot about being able to tell people what to do. Being able to say, you know what, I need help with this, and I'm going to have you specifically do this. That's something I needed to learn in my life, because most of the time I'm just like, I don't know, we need to get this done. But I don't ever specifically tell each person what their job is, and being able to do that gets the task done. And that's something that I think I'll be able to use throughout the rest of my life.
I learned you have to be confident, and you have to think quick on your feet and just go with it, and you can't second guess yourself.
But I'm really glad I got to do it, because it showed me a lot about what we learned in class, like in program management, the things like the cycles we learned about. I think when you're a group leader, you kind of see the full cycle of that. You get to plan, and then you get to see it carried out, and then you get to evaluate, and we've definitely
took away is being more confident in being able to manage schedules. Because usually I'm a go-with-the-flow kind of person. I just like being told what to do. But having to be the person that's in charge and being, or having to tell other people what to do, is a huge learning experience.
As a group leader, you got to see how to arrange people. You got to kind of take on that administrative position for a couple weeks and see how that runs. And it was cool because we only did it for 2 weeks and you got a partner, so it wasn't like... you weren't ever overwhelmed, and Dan was always there to help, so it was a really good learning experience.
It's okay to like tell people what to do and to delegate responsibilities, because in the end it just gets everything done faster. And as long as you do it in like a nice, like respectful way, and you know, you take their opinion into account and like what they want to do and how they are feeling, if you can take that into account and still like get everything done and be nice, then I feel like that is what makes a good leader, and I feel like
it's... So, today's Saturday.
And it was a super long 2 days where we haven't slept much, because all of our groups have been crazy. So Taylor was super excited to take a sledding today, and no one was really excited because we were all tired. But we have had the biggest blast of our life. Isn't that right, Taylor?
Yes! Very right!
Carly, how do you feel, man? I'm feeling awful. All right, people. How is the sledding going? Yeah. I'm actually... we're gonna take you up the sled hill because it's super hilarious to watch people go up this.
I just discovered that if you walk bow-legged up the hill, it's way easier.
How do you walk bow-legged?
Yeah, that's how I walk.
Alright, go!
So my takeaway from Badger would be, first, it was fun, but second, it was hard. It was super hard because for me it was a dramatic change from Florida and just from my lifestyle and, you know, stepping outside my comfort zone a little bit of just trying to, like, be focused and be determined and accomplish, you know, the goals and, you know, what they have here, and just trying to, like, be the best person I could be personally. And, like, a lot of, I've taken so much just, like, spiritually and mentally and physically because it has made me stronger. I learned a lot about just everything Badger has to offer, and, you know, being outside and working here, it's just, like, everything, like, work has, you know, transformed into my life and has, like, made me grow spiritually because, like, now, taking away from it, it's just, like, you know, I exceeded so far past my limits that, like, I want to go on a mission. And it's super cool now because I know it's what I need to do. And with Badger, I knew it was, like, something I needed to do, and I just didn't know what it had in store. But at the end, like, everything that's come together is, like, so worth it. And so that's my kind of takeaway.
I think my biggest takeaway from Badger Creek is the confidence to try new things. I am really scared of heights, and I'm really scared of being in front of people. I don't like a lot of attention on me all the time. And I had to do that up here. So at first it was really hard because I had to go rock climbing and, like, let go of, like, a rope so I would swing like 40 feet in the air. It was really scary, but in the end I think it gave me the confidence to be able to try new things and not be scared if something looks too hard or if I don't think I can do it. Just, like, push yourself another notch up, and I think that helped me a lot.
So I think one of the biggest takeaways for me from this is kind of confidence. I was with the branch president here. His name is President Wilson. He's super cool over our YSA ward. And he said something that really, like, kind of stuck with me. He said that what Badger Creek does for all of the people who come here is that it gives us confidence. It gives us the confidence that we can do what we want to do, that we can accomplish the things that we set our mind to, and it teaches us to trust the people around us. And I've really seen that happen. I know that out of the box experiences like this give people confidence. They give you the knowledge that you can learn anything you set your mind to, and that you're really capable of so much more than you ever realize, especially when you work together as a group. All of us girls who are here this semester, we all have our strengths. We all have great, great potential and just awesome personalities. And being able to join all of those together to work as one cohesive team was super awesome. I loved it. It was cool to see the way that we meshed together and the way that we worked together, and see our confidence grow in that as a group and as individuals. And I think that's my biggest takeaway, is that having these types of opportunities, being able to throw yourself into something you're not super comfortable with, in the end comes out so rewarding, with so much more confidence and self-assurance. And that's something that's really important.
What will you take away from your experience at Badger in general?
Okay.
Badger Creek was an amazing experience for me. And I kind of came here by chance. I was really scared to come here because I was going to be living with 7 other girls. And that can be really hard and difficult. And, like, we were just going to be, like, in the forest and everything. But, oh gosh, I don't want everyone to be here. I was really nervous to come here in the beginning, but it turned out to be, like, one of the best experiences I have ever had. It has, like, opened a whole new world to me. And, like, again, I think everyone says this, but, like, it really has changed, like, the way that I look at things and the way that I do things. And it has changed, like, the person that I am. I'm, like, a lot more, I'm,
a lot more loving, I think. Even though it might not seem like it, I can get kind of like frustrated or whatever. But I am a lot more loving, and I'm able to like open up to people a lot more, and I'm able to like, I don't know, I feel like I know myself a lot more, and I can like read people better, and I don't know. It really has like changed everything that I am. And one of the main things that I've learned from this semester, not exactly from like from work or school or anything, but just in general, is that like God loves everyone. He loves like all of his children, and I know that he loves me. Oh gosh. And I know that that sounds kind of cheesy, and it's like, well, yeah, duh, like, of course God loves you, but it's hard. It was like hard for me to see that before, and now I can see that, and I know that. I mean, I have like been living in his creations, and I've been living with his daughters. All semester long, and it's just been the greatest experience. And I can feel his love for me, and I know that he is always there for me, and he's there for every single one of us, no matter what. And I mean, that's something that I'm gonna have the rest of my life. Like, to know that God loves me, that's like, that's something that I can take with me forever. And it will definitely help me in every single area of my life, because I mean, God created me, and he created this life for me, and he knows what I need. And so if I can trust him and know that he loves me, like, anything is possible.
Go? Yeah, go.
Okay, so I think the biggest thing that I'll take away from my experience here at Badger is that we need to constantly be pushing ourselves, like getting out of our comfort zones, and that's how you learn the most. That's how you progress and how you grow, is you have to push yourself, and maybe you have to just put yourself in a situation where you will be pushed. You know, I did a lot of things this semester that I was not comfortable with necessarily. You know, I used a blowtorch, which was kind of freaky. I got a mouse out of a mouse trap, which is like my worst fear ever. And I learned how to belay and set up ropes courses and things I never really imagined myself being able to do. It was definitely an adventure, especially when things went wrong. I think adventure happens when things go wrong a lot of the time, but figuring out how to problem solve and how to just grow personally and grow together as a group, as a staff, and that was a really, really cool thing to see.
I think what I'll take away is that we all have the ability to be leaders, even if it scares us. We have the ability to like rise above things that are super fearful to us, and that, I don't know, Heavenly Father knows exactly what he's doing when he puts you in like uncomfortable situations. And I think that he knows the people that you need to learn. He'll put people around you who like their strengths or your weaknesses, so that you can grow and you have the opportunity to choose if you're like learn from that or not.
That's great, you guys are awesome. Really good job, little chickens. I think this mama hen is good for today.
In this situation, we're together for 3 months, and we work together and go to school together and sleep in the same room and are together 24/7. And you have the choice whether or not you're gonna learn from the people you're around and love them. I think I learned about what like true confidence is, like from other people. Has had their own huge thing of confidence that I've learned that makes them unique, and they're not afraid to be who they were born to be. And so I think to take away from this, the Heavenly Father created us to be unique and different. He created us to not be the same, because none of us are the same. And we're crazy in our own ways, but our dynamic created this like atmosphere of growth and love that I don't think I ever would have gotten anyplace else. Learned to be comfortable in my own skin, and that who the Lord made me to be was great, because everyone I was around was great. So that's
at Badger Creek. Okay, I know everyone says this, but I'm going to say it again. Badger Creek changed my life. I don't think that... I mean, I didn't know if I was meant to come here when I made the decision, but now I do know that I was supposed to be here. And one of the biggest things is the people I met and the relationships that I built. I think that all the girls here taught me so much, and they taught me so much about working hard, and I think my character changed throughout the semester just because I was here, just because of the experience I had here, and I will take that with me for the rest of my life.
Take the good from your experiences and move into the future. People sometimes get into the habit of always looking back at a certain time that they feel was better, or they romanticize something in the past, or they look forward to an idea that hasn't happened yet with kind of lofty visions of the past or the future. And we've had a wonderful time here together. But the real trick is to take the good lessons you've learned from the past and move into the future and be just as excited about what's coming as what you've been through, and not be in such a place that you think you always have to look back to the good times that you had here. That those good things you had here go with you through every step of the way, wherever it is that you go. And so to remember to hold on to those things and not to let yourself get stuck in a rut where you feel like you need to look back to find satisfaction and peace. So take those lessons, move forward, and live in the present, and don't be afraid to do those things in the present or today that will really do you the most good, and no one can figure that out but you.
Anyway, this is one of my favorite poems. Author is Lord Byron, and it goes like this. There is pleasure in the pathless woods. There is rapture on the lonely shore. There is society where none intrudes, by the deep sea and the music in its roar. I love not man the less, but nature more, for these are interviews in which I steal from all I may be or have been before, to mingle with the universe and feel what I cannot express, yet cannot all conceive.